Hey buddies, it's Andy here at Navigraph. Today we're gonna go over stars. A star is a standard terminal arrival routing starting at the end of the en route phase and leading all the way up to the initial approach fix. The star has some similarities to the SID, the standard instrument departure, which I showed you in the previous tutorial. And in that tutorial, I also showed you how you can set up the FMC in terms of the routing, including the star that we're gonna do in this tutorial. So if you haven't already done so, make sure to watch that video as well. But now let's head straight to the Gonzatou Sulu star at Malaga. Right, so here we are proceeding towards Gonza on the Gonzatou Sulu approach into runway 31 at Malaga. So the way I'm gonna do this is that I'm gonna show you a little bit how I have set up the plane for the approach, and then we're gonna go over the details a bit more in depth of the star. Cool, so looking here on the descent page, we can see that we got around 30 miles until our top of descent. I'd recommend you, if you're a beginner to setting up the plane, to normally start setting up around 200 miles before the top of descent point. And this top of descent point is based on a few figures that we have put into the FMC, like target speed, for example. I'll come back to that later. And then we have the figures in the forecast page, as you see here. I put in the QNH, the temperature, and the forecast winds that you can get from the descent wind request button and the PMDG, which is a nice feature to get an even more accurate figure for the top of descent. As you can see, I put in the transition level as well there. So now we're going to go back into the charts application and have a look at what we have here. So as you can see, we're following the east coast of Spain here, going down to Gonza, cutting the corner a bit from the flight plan. So I want to talk about a feature that we have in the application that I find really useful for these approaches. When you have a star and you have an approach, and then you have the airport chart as well. So instead of going to all the categories and scrolling between the approaches, you can just pin the ones that you need for the approach. And that will save you a lot of time when you do the approach, and also if you want to brief it. So here we have the Gonzatou Sulu star into Malaga. As you can see, we're proceeding towards Gonza already. The Gonza is the first point there with flight level 100 on the chart, and flight level 100 or above is in the FMC as well. I want to show you that I have set up the 113.55 in standby here for the Malaga VOR, which some points are defined by. So as you can see, we're proceeding to Incal after that, and then we're following the 29 distance arc there from the Malaga VOR that you have seen that I've set up. But we're gonna follow the GPS points if nothing unexpected happens. So after that, we're proceeding to Pisa, and that is the end of the star and the start of the approach. So I'm gonna continue with the approach, however we will brief this in more detail in later tutorials with the approach tutorials. So we have Pisa 4000 or above, flight level 110 or below, and then we're following the 18 DME arc 3000 or above. As you can see, the last point in the FMC is from the arc, as well as the first one here, 3000 or above as well. And then the Charlie Fox 31 2000 or above is the 14.7 Golf Alpha Alpha. And then we have the 1700 feet at Fox India 31, and then we're capturing the glide slope down to the runway. And then just briefly going over the points in the go around as well. So we're climbing a runway heading to Malaga VOR first of all. Malaga you can see in the bottom there in the FMC. And then when turning left, max 210 to intercept 269, Malaga to 7.7. And that's the Delta 269 H point in the FMC. And as you can see, speeds are in as well. Then we're turning right heading north, and then we're intercepting radial 147 to Mike Alfa Romeo. And that's in as well as the altitudes. Cool, so I'm moving over to the descent page here to show you what I was talking a little bit about earlier, target speed, and how this can affect the top of the descent point. So as you can see here, we get the reset MCP altitude message. So if you don't start the descent now, we will need some drag during the descent. But what if we put in 290 instead of 256 for the speed? That's going to give us 20 miles to the top of descent, because higher speed means higher drag. Cool, so I'm just gonna finish off here with the ILS. So we have the localizer 109, the small 9 set on active box 1 and 2. Courses 313 are set. And the landing altitude is set to 50 feet. And I have set the minimums for the approach as well. So last but not least here, we want to have a look at the airport chart just to give ourselves an idea of where we want to vacate. So it can be a bit hard if you don't have performance tools. We have to estimate a little bit. I reckon Echo 6 is about 2 kilometers to play with. So landing with flap 30 here is going to give us a ref speed of 147. That's put in the approach ref page. I'm using auto brake 2 for this one. And then if we have to, we can always use some manual braking in the end. So that's the important things covered for the STAR as well as the setup. Right, so that was a little bit about STARs, guys. Hope that you found this tutorial useful for you. And if you haven't already done so, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram for even more content. And as usual, write a comment in the comment section below if you have any specific requests for future tutorials. Till next time, take care. See you. Bye.